So that amount be a slightly over exaggerated sort of finger flutter to say hello. Finger fluttering has become somewhat mandatory at the start. As I still get incredibly triggered by them. And I feel like seem really weird at the start of every video, so hopefully that really comes across well. Flood, 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 flood. Flood, 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 flood. I think it does. But also, it helps get you into that level, sort of tingly way to warm up your brain and your senses. Before it is presented with a bunch of new sounds and different ways of making them. So that could be visually or by sound as well. So it seems to me that you appear to be in the right state to receive a whole new batch of tingles, a whole new selection of sounds. So after realizing that this new sound could be utilized, it was then I thought, now is the time to make an ASMR. And introduce these triggers to you. So it's a kind of new sound. It's something different and something which I found unexpectedly. And the unexpected things are always to me the best triggers and the best way to get triggered for ASMR and feel good. So what with me here is a tea light, but this isn't an ordinary tea light. This is a Fred tea light. But what's different about this one, apart from containing tons and tons of diamonds, is this tea light is textured, and this is cracked glass. I can't remember if that's the right name for it, but this means that there's texture around the glass. It's still obviously a perfectly good tea light. The cracked glass is just a texture glass either side of it, but it does create this nice texture, and to me that sound sounds like raindrops. And as I'm sure you know by now, I like to compare ASMR sounds with real life sounds, and something which is a great favorite of mine with something that a material that gets rubbed or something which creates that sandy beachy wave type thing, then that to me is a trigger and something I can relate to in an actual environment. This to me has that real nice, just gentle raindrops at the back of your head, and it makes me feel very trigger worthy. So hopefully you can hear that sort of raindrop sound that these cracked glass tea lights give. But that's just an added bonus of these tea lights. As you can see, it has the cracked bits around the outside, which makes good sounds. But it's what's inside here which I really like so much, and it's just the way of all those little diamonds in that thing right here that really started to trigger my ASMR. And this is one of those things which came unexpectedly. Like I said, it became something which I thought would or should deserve some ASMR attention. So, before we go and explore the inside of this cut glass tea light, what kind of completes these, which I think are really cool, is a little light which I got for it. Not a tea light, but something which would go inside the tea light itself. You pop it in, and once it's in there, because of all the diamonds, it would reflect the light and look really sort of atmospheric and tingle inducing. So I have the light here with me, and it's literally this tiny little thing, and it's just these LEDs at the top, and I'm not sure if they're waterproof, but literally all you do is just screw it into place, and then that light turns on. And this is actually quite bright, so you can see why it kind of becomes tingle inducing. So we have the little light, and with the diamonds in it, so all we do is just pop that light in there, and it's literally just delicately prise it in there until it gets to the bottom. And then it has this really nice glow to it, so that means it's ready to be played around with and manipulated for you to get triggered from. And this was something which I was doing, was literally for a long time just get as many of those sounds as I could. So, you will very delicately move the diamonds around more ear attention. Sound of the diamonds as they move around from each other, and I think it looks really good with the light in it, as diamonds are of course meant to shine, so this helps those artificial diamonds. Of course I'm treating them like real ones for some reason, I'm not sure. for me, they carry that cross between the shattered glass type raindrops, and once pushed together, it has that sort of snow sort of texture, that rub that you get. And for me, that's very, very pleasing to my ASMR senses. And with this, it's extremely delicate, but the sound justifies it. So I have something with me which might go well with this particular tea light thing. And like the majority of my things which are ASMR orientated, which are quite long in the form of a stick, it becomes a relative of snip sticks. It's a close relative, and I have it here with me. And this is snip hook, or hooks, shall I say. These, of course, are just 10 pegs, but these ones are a kind of 12 round, which when you move them, they create that quite delicate, everything's delicate with all the sounds there, but it creates that quite delicate metallic sound, unlike the other snip sticks in the last video. Because they were quite thin, they made a very different type of sound. So it's always just accumulating the sounds together and manipulating them where I find my ASMR happiness. So we just get back the tea light. I don't think we're going to need both the hooks, but we use them. What the hell? Both of them. And, oh, you guessed it. Tea light and they're great for making that really nice sound of diamond. If you're any good at chopsticks, and you could probably pick one of these out meticulously one by one, but I'm not, and I'll try. No, I don't know why I'll try such things, but of course it's all in the name of ASMR. ASMR-inducing light to make or to activate the diamonds, and then hooks, which will make the perfect combination to create a different sound, and hopefully something which was worthy enough to trigger your ASMR. Artificial raindrops from ear to ear. Something a little bit different, and hopefully it contained enough sounds in there, a whole variety of sounds which you found relaxing and you enjoyed, and it was something for you to add to your ASMR catalogue, like the finger fluttering, and the metal hooks. It all just spawns from different ideas, and then I'll try and put it together to make an ASMR video, and always feel like I go off on way too many tangents, but I hope that it was enough to make you feel nice and triggered and you enjoyed it. For me, I really like the sounds of those diamonds and the raindrops. It was just kind of the way it was all put together, which started to give me that ASMR sensation. So hopefully it did the same to you. So I hope you enjoyed it. And hopefully that gave you plenty of triggers or relaxation throughout. And I'll be seeing you again soon. Next video. Cheers.